What's up, guys? It's Chris Majestic. So I've been asked several times to do a smart home tour, and I think I've put it off long enough. So today we're going to be doing the Majestic smart home tour, so stay tuned. Now, there's a lot of smart home gadgets that I want to cover, but I'm going to try to make this video as short as I can. Now, I know two of the most popular smart home gadgets out there right now is the Amazon Echo and the Google Home. So if you have one, you might want to go ahead and mute it so I don't trigger it 100 times in this video. Now, what's funny is that I actually have both the Amazon Echo and the Google Home sitting right next to each other in several rooms in my house. And I actually use both of them to control just about everything in my house with my voice. This includes lights, TVs, music, thermostats, and even my house alarm. Now, I do have to say that I prefer the Google Home a little bit better than the Echo since it's better at answering certain questions, but sometimes yelling out Alexa just feels better. Alexa, turn on CBS.
Okay.
Alexa, tell Harmony to increase the volume by 3.
Okay.
I like awkwardness. Hey Google, turn on the house alarm.
No problem, the house is secure.
Hey Google, set the downstairs to 73 degrees.
You got it, setting the downstairs to 73 degrees.
Now, one really cool thing that I use the Google Home for is whole home music. And the best way to do this if you have other speakers around your house is to buy Chromecast audio and connect it to your soundbar or your speakers. Then you can just tell Google Home to play music everywhere and it'll actually play the music in sync around your whole house. It's pretty awesome and it's a nice cheap alternative to Sonos. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 I also use the Google Home to play videos with my voice on the Chromecast, or you can do the same thing with the Amazon Echo and the Fire Stick. And speaking of TV control, the hub that I use to control my TVs is the Logitech Harmony Hub. So this thing lets you control your TV, soundbar, home theater, or just about anything that uses a regular remote. So you just tell it what devices you have and then just sit it somewhere in the room and it uses infrared to control those devices. So this means you do have to have one in each room, but it does allow you to control everything with your phone or your voice using the Echo or the Google Home. Hey Google, let's watch a movie.
Aw yeah, you already know I gotcha, bro. Let's do this.
So I have it linked with my SmartThings Hub so that it turns off the lights in the basement when I start a movie and turns the lights back on after the movie's over. So as you can see, it can even control the smart LED strips that I have around my screen and my seats in my home theater. And these LEDs actually work with Google Home and Alexa as well, so you can control the color and brightness with your voice, or you can just use the Magic Home app to control them with your phone if you want. So not only am I a big fan of smart home products, but I'm also a really big fan of actual home automation. In other words, I want things to happen automatically instead of pulling out my phone or using my voice to do things. And to do this, I use one of my favorite smart home devices, which is the Samsung SmartThings Hub. So SmartThings is a home automation hub that links with a bunch of smart home devices like Philips Hue, thermostats, door locks, smart sensors, the Amazon Echo, and the Google Home. It also works with generic smart switches and light bulbs that you can find for pretty cheap on Amazon. So nearly every light switch in my house is a smart light switch. So some of them are actual smart dimmer switches, and the rest of them use a micro switch, which is basically a small box that you install behind your original light switch that turns it into a smart switch. Now, in my opinion, smart light switches are more cost effective than buying a bunch of smart light bulbs, especially for places that have a lot of bulbs. So I also have several door sensors connected to my SmartThings Hub, which I use to automate several different things like turning on certain lights when I open up the door at night. And you can even use the hub as a house alarm and get alerts if something opens when you're not home. So for example, I can monitor and control my garage doors from SmartThings. So if I leave the house and forget to close the garage door, it'll notify me on my phone and automatically close the door for me and even tell me if the door closed successfully, which is freaking awesome. Another cool thing that I use SmartThings for is water alerts. So I have 3 water sensors placed around my house and I have SmartThings configured to call and text both me and my wife whenever any of them detects water, which has already saved me twice. And another cool thing I have set up is that when both me and my wife leave the house, the SmartThings hub will automatically turn off all the lights and TVs, check to see if we left open any doors, and turn on the house alarm for us. Another smart home device that I use is the Nest Learning Thermostat. It looks nice, it's easy to set up and use, and it tries to learn your schedule and save you some money on your heating and cooling bill. Now, after I set the schedule a couple years ago, the only time I really interact with it is when I tell Alexa or Google Home that it's too hot or too cold, but otherwise it works really well. So one thing that ties all the smart home devices in my house together is the Android tablet in my kitchen. So this is a super cheap 10-inch Android tablet that I got on Amazon for around 60 or 70 bucks, and I have it secured to the wall in my kitchen using the same locking strips that you use for an easy pass in your car. And I do have a charger running to it so I can easily charge it if the battery runs low. So this thing has all the smart home apps that I use installed on it, and I also use it to monitor my cameras, including my Ring Doorbell Pro. So if you're not familiar with the Ring Doorbell, it's a smart doorbell that's connected to the cloud. So whenever it senses motion or the button is pressed, it'll automatically send the video out to the cloud and notify you on your phone for you to see who's there. So the doorbell works really well as long as it has a strong Wi-Fi connection. And I have the tablet configured to automatically open the Ring app whenever it senses motion or if somebody presses the doorbell. That way I can see who's at the door just by looking at the tablet on the wall. And speaking of cameras, I do have 6 Amcrest PoE cameras mounted outside of my house that are all wired to an Amcrest MVR that records several months worth of video. Now these cameras are full HD and they have a really, really sharp image. They are a bit of a pain to install since they have to be wired, so I do recommend professional installation, but they do work really well. Now Amcrest does have their own smartphone app, but I do like to use the Android TinyCam app since it does a great job of pulling up multiple cameras quickly so I can see what's going on. I also have a few random Wi-Fi cameras around the house that are linked to TinyCam as well. All right, guys, that's gonna do it for the tour. If you have any questions about home automation or any of the devices that I mentioned, go ahead and check the video description since I've done several reviews and videos on most of this stuff. I've also put Amazon links to a bunch of the devices that I use in the video description, so you can check those out as well. Thanks for watching. Go ahead and leave your questions and comments in the comment section. I'll respond to your questions. Go ahead and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys in the next video.